So I have like a couple slides, but I really want to do demo because I told everyone for my preview here that I was going to pack everything I know about agents in 12 minutes. So this is going to be a rapid fire thing about SharePoint agents. But what I want you to see is how you can work with them. And I want you to walk away from this call with the confidence to just go out there and start creating these agents. So that's what we're going to do today. So just a quick introduction. This is, sorry, the groundwork here. We'll go over what M365 Copilot is because you have to have a Copilot license to be able to create SharePoint agents. And I'll talk about the specific licensing that is needed for that. I will also go over just what's an agent, what's a SharePoint agent, like, because I know that when we get into the world of Copilot and agents, it kind of starts to get a little blurry about all the things that are out there. So I'm going to bring some clarity to that. And then also, let's actually see the SharePoint agents in action and then some things to consider if we have time at the end. But just a little bit about me. My name is Heidi Jordan. I'm a modern workplace manager at Avanade. I live in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. I am a SharePoint girl living in a Power Platform world because SharePoint is my first love and it probably always will be. But the Power Platform has also changed my life and what I do. So fluent in all the designer and on-prem things in the SharePoint world. I am a Microsoft MVP for business applications. Contact information is on the screen there. If you have some questions after the call, please feel free to reach out to me. I'm happy to talk SharePoint, just as the other presenter was just saying, I can talk that all day. So also, there's a little icon on the screen there, the bite-sized M365. Another MVP, Pam DeGraffenried, and I started a little video series, and it's like 12 to 15 minute videos. It's like our own little community calls, honestly, where we do some demos on things that we've learned about M365 all over the board. So feel free to check that out. And let's go into the groundwork. So Copilot. So first of all, let's start with what is M365 Copilot? So M365 Copilot is really just an AI-generated assistant that is embedded into your Office applications. So think about those tools you use every day, like Teams, Outlook, Word, Excel. It's embedded in those systems, and it's also it utilizes large language models under the hood and also your Microsoft Graph data. So you can basically use your natural language prompts to ask this AI assistant questions, and it can bring back answers of things that it knows about your Microsoft Graph. So the emails that you send, Teams messages, you know, documents that you have access to, all the things. That's kind of what M365 Copilot is on a very high level. It is also built on the Microsoft security standards. So anything you're asking Copilot is not sent outside the tenant. It's not trading any models, anything like that. So that in a nutshell is what M365 Copilot is. So what's an agent? So an agent is a virtual assistant that can help you with, you know, those processes. So what I kind of tell people is, you know, an agent is really the next step beyond Microsoft 365 Copilot. Like M365 Copilot does a great job with those conversations, like, you know, help me refine this, help me, you know, create this. But then an agent is something that is actually trained on that data, and they can provide you better, more eloquent answers to your questions. So you'll see on the screen that there's a bunch of different applications and a bunch of different ways we can consume agents across the Microsoft platform. But what I want to really bring to light is, what is a SharePoint agent? So a SharePoint agent is that automated assistant, but it is actually built on top of your SharePoint documents. So it can perform things like you can ask questions of it, you can help it summarize files, generate content. And then it's also can be scoped to everything on your SharePoint site, SharePoint libraries. You can put multiple things together, which I'll show you. But the kicker there on the bottom is that it does require a Microsoft 365 Copilot license to be able to create these SharePoint agents or a Copilot Studio pay as you go. I don't want to get into licensing discussions, but I did want to put it out there that you do need some sort of Copilot licensing to be able to use these SharePoint agents to create them and to consume them, both of them. All right, so let's actually flip over to demo now. I'm going to switch the screen share 1 second, and then we will do some building. And I have a SharePoint online upgrade site that I'm going to use for these demos today. So let me grab my notes. All right. So looking here is this is the SPO upgrade site. So let me close this. So the first place that you can use SharePoint agents, we're going to start from the top and we're going to dig into how we actually customize and make these things. But the first place that you can use agents is at the site level. So if you look on the top, you'll see the Copilot icon here. And then that's going to open up the site panel, which is the site agent. So every This one's actually a different one because I've set it to be a different default one. So I'm going to change it back to the site agent. But this is the site agent that comes when you don't even have to create this. It just comes with the site when you have that M365 Copilot license. So here I can ask this questions about the site. So I, for example, I could just ask, you know, what are some documents that are have been recently updated on this site? So this is, again, the conversational, like, don't think about prompt engineering in a heavy way. I'm just asking a question like, hey, here's a site, like, tell me the things that were recently updated out here. So as you can see, now it's going to give me some answers like the homepage was edited. There was an agent that was edited yesterday morning. The site is pretty empty. So if you put this on top of a site that has a lot of content, you're going to get much better results. But this is just kind of what it brings back of high level. So then I thought, all right, well, if I'm thinking I'm a new user and I am, you know, interacting with a SharePoint site, like, please explain what the site is and what its purpose is. So I'm using it to get a little bit deeper than just asking for that document retrieval. So you can see that this, you know, it contains a welcome section. There are some learning resources on the site. Here's some visual content. So it's just giving me kind of a high level of this essentially empty site. I can continue to ask questions like this. I tried yesterday, like, something, please list documents and libraries that were not modified in the past year. I thought maybe that would start to help me, you know, the archival is always a common question. And, you know, when we get SharePoint, we get all kinds of stale data. Like, how do we use agents to help clean that up? This one is probably not the best example. I put that out there on purpose, but this was not really giving me much to pull back. This is too high level for a site agent, but this might be a better prompt for an agent in like a document library. So now what I want to do is dive a little deeper and show you where something like this would be more relevant. So the other thing too, I want to point out is an agent is not enterprise search. They're not the same thing, okay? Enterprise search does a wonderful job of you just go in and search for something and it brings it back, like an employee handbook. I could go to this site and ask, hey, is there an employee handbook on this site? But then I would have to know that there's an employee handbook on the site to be able to ask the agent. So don't treat this as enterprise search. Treat this as that more conversational, you know, asking questions like it's a person. So moving on to the actual agent demo then, I have we're going to create one from scratch together. So I have just a document library that has a whole bunch of meeting notes. So it probably looks familiar to a lot of people that work in large organizations that have a whole bunch of meeting notes. So what I want to do is layer an agent on top of these notes. Then I can start to ask questions about what's inside of these notes. So in the ribbon up here, you can see that it says create an agent. So I can click on that and then I can be done. Like, that is all you need to do to create a SharePoint agent. It is a one click, like, you're good to go and you can start asking questions of it, which is awesome. But if you want to add in some more things, like maybe you want to customize the welcome prompt or, you know, do some starter prompts or even the sources, you can just click on edit here. And then now I am in, so I can change a little bit about this agent. So zooming in, I can give it a name. Why does this name matter? So let me go back to the homepage just for a second. So right when we went to the site agent here, you notice that there was a dropdown and there's a whole bunch of things listed. So the name matters because that is where you'll find the name of your agent is in that dropdown. So if you name everything agent or SharePoint upgrade agent, like, it's going to be hard to distinguish which one you're trying to talk to. So make sure that that name is distinct. So I'm going to go back to, and I'm going to name this one CC demo, community call demo, so we know. You can change the logo of it if you want. And then there's a purpose here. It says, please just provide a brief description for the agent's objective. So what I do for this is I actually just go to Copilot and I have it help me with this. I go right into Copilot chat and I tell it, I'm creating a SharePoint agent grounded on meeting minutes. Help me, give me a purpose for this agent. And then it spit out this response for me that this agent assists users by retrieving and summarizing, et cetera, et cetera. So I use Copilot to generate that for me. You know, works smarter, not harder. So now let's go into the sources. This page, there's a lot going on. So I want to simplify this. This is essentially where your agent is pulling the information. So right now I can see that it is pulling information from this SPO upgrade site and it's pulling from the Documents 2 library. So there are 10 documents in that site, but right here is the most important thing, is it's up to 20 sources. I thought that meant like 20 documents, but what this means is 20 essentially different pipes. So you can have 20 sites, you can have 4 sites and 16 libraries, or 4 documents, 12 libraries, and 8. It's a combination of multiple things. The for governance sake, I mean, the more scope you can have your agent, the better. Obviously, that's just, you're going to have better performance with it. But you don't need to be so limited that it's like less than a hard number of 50 or anything like that. So 20 is kind of the general rule of thumb is what you can have for your knowledge sources. So I have another library on the site called Learning, and I know there's a document in there that I also want my agent to include in its responses. So I can click on, I can click here to add additional libraries from the site. So I am on my SPO upgrade site in the documents library. I can change this to Learning, and then I know that there's this upgrade project plan that I want to include. So I'm going to check that as well. And you can see that it popped up that 1 of 19 selected. So then I have 19 more places I can choose to ground my data. So now I can see its documents library and that one document. If I wanted to add another site, I would just click here and search for that URL, and then I can add documents and things from other sites. The last one is behavior. So this shows me just how that agent is going to react. So on the right side, you can see that this is the welcome message. I also asked Copilot again to give me a good welcome message. So I could, you know, I asked it to be an engaging welcome message. I could ask it to be professional, snarky, whatever we want. So here is the welcome message for my agent. I also asked it to give me some good starter prompts that, you know, a user, if someone's coming to the meeting minutes library, what do you think are the prompts that they might want to see most often? Think about those commonly used scenarios. So I'm just pasting those in, the ones that Copilot gave me. And you can see these are all changing on the right side as I do that. And then the last one is agent instructions. So this one is basically, do you want it to use a specific tone, like any limitations, don't talk about this, et cetera. So again, I asked Copilot chat to give me that. And this gave me a whole long thing about you're an AI assisted agent. Your job is to maintain professional, clear tone. And then it also down here, do not, you know, provide opinions or speculate on meeting outcomes, like give it a little bit more instruction there on what to do. All right, so that's our agent. It is built. So I'm going to save and close. So you'll notice that when we create this, so the agent's opening in the right side so we can start talking to it. It also adds a file here, a CC demo agent. So these agents live as .agent files in the library that you just created it. So this is kind of along the lines of like Power BI, it's private till you share it kind of thing. So this agent is here for me until I share it with others. If others have access to this library, they'll be able to see this agent. But if I want to make it available in that dropdown, so that all users can interact with it, I need to make it an approved agent. So if you click on the ellipsis right here, there's this set as approved, and then that will actually move it to your site assets library, and then it will show in this dropdown when you first enter the site. I'm not going to show that process for the sake of time here, but let's open that agent again, and let's just ask it a question. So I have, what are some decisions that were made about migration timelines? So this is great for, I think, stakeholders, you know, people that aren't there in the week-to-week or day-to-day of the project. They can just come in and see the notes, and they can start to ask questions like, what were the decisions that were made? But also, you know, is there anything holding up this project, and what were the actions taken to move this forward? Or, you know, list out all the tasks that were assigned to people, and did we accomplish those? You know, think of some of those actual things that you would ask a project manager. Those are the things that you could ask your agent now. So you can see that it brought out my migration timeline, it put it into phases. It's got these little footnotes, so it's actually pointing at the files that it found the answers in. So I could click that, and then it would open it up in the notes that it actually found it in. So that's a quick and dirty, like, how do you create the agent? How do you scope it out? A little bit about customization, but I really want to quickly show you how to use it. So you can use it in the context of this library here. So I can just go into the library, open the agent file, and then I can use it there. You can also use it in a couple other ways. They've recently added a new web part called Agent Link. If I scroll down here, there is an Agent Link web part. So let me just show you where that is if I edit this page. So zoom back out. If I want to add in a web part, there is this new agent link. And essentially what this does is it just puts a link to the agent right on the homepage. So if I republish this, and then I'll click on this meeting minutes agent so you can see, I can click on that, and then it's going to open up that the agent in the side panel here. So that's one place that you can interact with that agent. You can also come in and click on the Copilot at the top here, and then you'll see that drop down of the different agents. This is not agents just on this site. This is agents from all across my tenant too. You see this one's from a different site. So that's another place you can get to agents. But another one, my favorite one is in Teams. So I have added, once you publish your agent, there's a little, if you click on the ellipsis again, let me show you. Go back to this one for a second. I could show you. You can generate a link to share in Teams, and then you can talk to it in Teams. So right here, this copy link for Teams, that is where you can copy that link. All you have to do is copy the link, drop it right into the chat here, and then it will add it to that conversation. So then now you can see here, I just at mentioned that agent. So I said at mention the agent and just ask it, what are the latest meeting notes? And what it actually did too is before it gave me this response, it gave me a preview of the response because Pam is a guest in my tenant and she didn't actually have access to that SharePoint data. So it gave me a preview to make me, validate that it's okay to share that information before it put it in the chat. So a couple different ways to interact with those agents. And I know I'm right about time, so I'm going to stop talking. Go try SharePoint agents. Let me know if you have any questions.